नमस्ते, गुड आफ्टरनून टू एवरीबॉडी। होप आई एम ऑडिबल।
यस
हेलो,
मैम।
एम आई ऑडिबल?
यस मैम, यू आर ऑडिबल।
यस मैम,
थैंक यू, थैंक यू। सो वंस अगेन, ओम नमो भगवते धनवंतरये अमृत कलशहस्ताय सर्वामय विनाशनाय त्रिलोक लोचनाय धन्वंतरये विष्णवे नमः, विष्णवे नमः, विष्णवे नमः। एट द आउटसेट I would like to thank the organizers of Global Ayurveda Festival, especially Dr. Suresh Kumar, who has given me an opportunity to put my subject before you all. This subject, because I being a woman practitioner, I've been in this field from past, as they said, around 3 years. Being a clinician, most of the patients what we get during a day, 60% of the patients be among women. In that, most of them will have the problems with is concerned to menstruation. So now I'm taking you all to a bird's eye view of the problems a woman faces from the day time of menarche to menopause. So woman, according to Ayurveda, Sri in Ayurveda. What do they say about Sri in Ayurveda? Women were studied at various stages of her life and health guidelines are given as they understood. Civilization and culture of society is a gift of woman to the world. Mother, as you all know, is the architect of the society, as children are future of the world. Motherhood is the most cherished dream of every woman. Today, a girl is tomorrow's mother, as the process of conception, delivery, duties of caring, feeding, nurturing, and development of the child is the prerogative of the woman. So, now, according to Ayurveda, Srihi Moolam Apatyanam, Srihi Rakshati Rakshata, Janani Janma Bhumishta, Svargadapi Gariyas. So, woman is the root cause of progeny, as you all know, and she will protect if she is protected. So, it's the bound duty of the society and the family to protect the woman first. If she has been protected, she will protect the rest of them, the children, the family, the society, everybody. Now, see, unlike men, the woman has about the important 5 stages in woman is life from pre-menarche stage to menopause. So what do the Ayurveda says about it? The first stage is called as Bala. See, till the stage of Bala, first 10 years of life, it is almost a boy and a girl are equal in every aspect. The milestones after the birth and the intelligence, the memory, and whatever the games they play, everything will be equal till the age of 10. What happens when a bala, the Gauri Kanya Rohini, called as Gauri also, Kanya also, she is said, and Rohini, he is first 10 years of. Then the stage of Kumari comes, is called as Premenarche or Mukdast. That is between 10 to 12 years of life. And then the Rajomati, that is Menarche, establishes, that is real menstruation starts from the age of 13 to 16 years. But of course, of late we are seeing, you know, very early stages of menstruation. Maybe a girl starts menstruating at the age of 8, 9. I have seen at the age of 8 also menstruation starts for a girl, because of this lifestyle changes now and the exposure to all these like social medias and other things, the girl matures faster now. And then Yuvati is the next stage, wherein is also called as Yuva, Taruni, Praudavastha. That is between 17 years to 40th year of age. Then the Praudavastha, that is Adhirudha or Pragalbha, that is where the menstruation is, the cessation happens. So what do the Kumari pre-menarche period say? See, in Kumari period, what we have to say, 2-3 years prior to attaining the menarche. So at this stage, the menstruation flow will not have been head. So body, what all changes we find in a girl? Body height increases relatively the faster. Till that 10 years of age, she grows all according to other child. But suddenly the height raises relatively faster. The rate of growth of the body is higher. The development of secondary sexual characters as notable. Psychological changes, as you all see, the development of the breast and hairs under the axilla portion and the pubic portions, they start developing. And the psychological changes, and the girl becomes shy. You know, you can notice the girls around this stage, they become little shy because they're very wary of their changes in the body, the physical body that's happening, and sometimes even little withdrawn. So they don't mix. At this stage, what happens? They become shy and they don't mix freely with the other people at the home or even outside. So this period is dominated according to Ayurveda with Kapha and Pitta. Though Artava is secreted as Upajato or Prasadato, throughout the life, it becomes active only when the girl attains. So then it is converted as Artava. Due to the activation of the hormones, majority of girls have slight watery or mucoid discharge. As you, I think you all might have experienced this. While it need not be any concern, pathological concern, just a slight watery or mucoid discharge. Having typical odor is not a bad odor. Typical odor, if there is any excessive watery or mucoid discharge, and then treatment becomes inevitable. So many girls, you know, they are very shy to express and they come to our clinic with their mothers. We will only ask the prashna, you know, like the question, see, what is that? Do you have any white discharge? Does your panties wet sometimes? Like that we have to ask. Then they will open up. And then when they say that there is a watery discharge, better just view them externally, because we are not supposed to do any PVR examination. So just view them and then advise about the hygiene, what they will have to practice. It is very, very important, because you know they use a public toilet in the school and outside places and all that. So there is a lot of contamination, fungal infection they have developed, and then they are shy to express whether it is itching in that area or whatever. So you have to tell them the basic hygiene at that level than giving any medicine. And then tell their mothers to see that part, and then tell her how to manage that cleanliness about her area. Then comes the Rajomati Menarche stage. This is an indication of beginning of reproductive life. See, in Ayurveda, such a beautiful statement like antenatal care should begin when the girl matures. It is not that antenatal care when she becomes pregnant. So it is now, it is so much important. We all now as doctors tell them pre-conception counseling. They are pregnant, we do a lot of post-delivery every time. So this is very important that antenatal care, whatever the antenatal care, what we mean, it is a lifestyle again. See what happens, mityahara, vihara, vichara. All these are the problem in getting some diseases. To avoid that, you teach the family, you teach the mother, what are the things to be followed, what kind of food to be given at that stage, and what kind of rest she has to take, what kind of activity she has to perform in that time. So please advise the mother, so that is called as antenatal care. And if you follow this kind of Ayurvedic way of lifestyle changes, you will definitely become a very good mother, and you will bear a very good healthy child, and there will not be any problem because of these immune-related issues. So the common problems, what are all the common problems during menarche? I will just come one by one to help them understand physical and mental changes, as I said. So you tell them that this is a common natural phenomena which happens to a girl child, physical changes, you please accept it. And then nowadays, of course, the girls are very well versed with this app, mobile apps and all, they will know everything. But still in the school or when they come to the clinic with parents, you have to advise them how you have to maintain your hygiene, how you have to go all along with this kind of changes in your body. The second problem, the major problem we come across is menorrhagia. The menorrhagia is the word which heavy bleeding during the period. See, when once the girl start menstruating, many a times we see that for another 6 months, she may not have her periods. So then she starts regular bleeding once masanumasika. Then what happens, sometimes few girls, they start bleeding very heavily during the periods. Instead of bleeding for 5 days, they bleed for 7 days, 8 days, 10 days also. So other things are metrominorrhagia. So there is no regularity in the cycles. Menstrual cycle, as you all know, once in 28 days. Minimum period of 21 days is considered between 21 to 28 days or 30. So below 21 days, it is called as polymenorrhea. If it is irregular, like once it comes in 28 days, 10 time comes in 35 days or 45 days. These are all called as regular period. I'll come to that. So in case of menorrhagia, what you can do? First thing what you have to add, they will be in the age of, you know, school going girl. So we have to tell them the rest. And then lying down position with the head low position is very much advised when there is anything. And the simple medicines at home, what all you can do is also you can give what usually, according to Ayurveda, the Pushyanuga, you might have all heard about Pushyanuga Churna, it also comes in the form of tablets. That is the number one medicine which can be given during heavy bleeding. Any unwanted discharges in a female, the first drug of choice should be Pushyanuga. So that you can give along with, you know, Chandra Prabhavati is also good, but sometimes as it is a genitourinary tract is very close together, because of some discharges in the vagina, there can be also problem in the urinary bladder. So better selection of Chandra Prabhavati is also given. And then if the bleeding is very heavy, I would always advise Panchavalkala Kashaya Churna. The Panchavalkala, you know, as Ashwatha, Nigrodha, Udambara, they are all the medicines. The bark of these trees are collected and made into powder form. And in the form of Kashaya, if you give Panchavalkala Kashaya Churna, in the form of Kashaya, you make it give in a day, two to three times a day, the bleeding will subside. Then you advise them how to go about the next cycle. The next comes the amenorrhea part. What do we mean by amenorrhea? Amenorrhea is the period of lack of periods. Sometimes what happens, a girl matures, you know, she, that is called as menarche, that period starts, menstruation. But afterwards, she will not have a regular period at all for the period of 2 years, 3 years, even up to the age of 16 years. So what I do recommend them is, see, you don't worry till the age of 16 years, because process of ovulation only starts after the age of 16 years. Though a girl starts menstruating around 12 years, the process of ovulation takes a little bit delay. So what you have to advise is amenorrhea period, if she doesn't even have the regular periods till the age of 16 years, then it is a time to interfere with the medication. As we all know about the famous drug aloe vera, that is Kumari, the name itself indicates it is the best medicine to give children or girl of that age to induce periods. So that has to be followed by the regular medication. There are so many medications like, you know, Ashoka, we have Ashoka, just by giving Ashoka Rishta, you with the Lodra, you regularize your periods by giving these medicines. Simple form of syrup or kashayas or arishtas you have to give. So don't ever too much medicate, because it's a natural process that by the age of 18 years, he should settle down with the regular. Then comes the problem of leucorrhea. What is leucorrhea? Leucorrhea is an unwanted discharge of white discharge. As I said, they are in the premenarche stage, there can be some kind of thin discharges, which is not pathological. But when there is leucorrhea happens, there's a thick discharge, bluish color discharge, or a curdy discharge, or a powdery discharge, which also speaks of some fungal infection. So depending on the doshas, like, you know, vata, kapaja, or pitaja doshas, we have to treat the leucorrhea. In case of girls who are not married, they are not supposed to do any yoni prakshalana or anything, but just advise them a good hygiene. And panchavalkala kashaya lotion also can be used as for washing in that area. And then, as I said, Pushyanuga Churna is number one that you can give with Chandra Prabhavati. Or Trivanga is also number one drug to treat leucorrhea. Trivanga Basma can be given. Trivanga in the form of tablet also given. And we have so many products like Shilajito and Trivanga, all that. All these can be given to control the leucorrhea with especially hygiene management in that area. Next comes the dyspareunia, which is very bad. You know, many girls I have seen, even many women, they miss their school, they miss their college, they miss their work because of this. Yeah, they come just crying to the clinic, you know, holding their abdomen, very bad pain, history of vomiting and all that. That dyspareunia is a painful period. There are different causes for dyspareunia. According to Ayurveda, na vata druta, as you all know, vata is the main dosha which causes all this problem. Dyspareunia is number one among them. So we have to tackle vata kopa in that case. What happens, like, many a times because of this wrong junk food habits, all these young girls, they eat all these fast foods and all that. They don't have the timings, don't eat properly, they don't eat nourishing food. What happens is a constipation. Apanavayu dushti happens. Because of apanavayu dushti, there is dyspareunia. So how do you treat that? You have to check that apanavayu dushti. What is the best drug of choice for treating apanavayu dushti? It is the Sukumara Kashaya, Sukumara Ghrita is the best medicine which you can give them. So if you give them, the Apanavayu also clears, and then the constipation is also cleared, and then the Vega Varodha and also be started, stopped. So giving this medicine, the pain will gradually down. In case of women, what happens? There is an endometriosis, very common word now. Then I will come to it later. So these are all the problems in the rheumatic period which we have to treat according to the Ayurveda medicine. So next, after the marriage, what is the next problem? This is my, actually infertility is my branch specialized into. I have been having a lot of infertility patients, both male and female, and also the allopathic doctors who are having gifts also, they will refer for infertility treatment with us as a supportive treatment, as a detox treatment, as to improve the quality of egg, and for the implantation purpose, they all refer the cases to me. So what is infertility? Failure to achieve conception by a couple of mature age, having normal coitus. Having normal coitus means during the particular appropriate period of menstrual cycle. Maybe if a woman is having regular cycles of about 8 to 30 days cycle, probably the ovulation will happen between the day 10 of the cycle to day 20th, between that. So that period is called as appropriate period. They have to have a normal coitus, normal sexual intercourse during the period, at least for 1 year, is termed as infertility. If even having the proper contact, proper timings, still they are, she is, a woman is unable to conceive, then they are called as having suffering from infertility problem. According to Charaka Samhita, the term Vandya represents fertility. And the woman who suffers from Vandya is called as Vandyatva. So Purusha Loka Samvavada, as you all know, that Ayurveda believes that person is equal to universe. Whatever formed entities are in the universe, the same are in person and universe. The ideal factors for conception, Rutu, season, that is, I told you just now, the ovulation time is called as the Rutu. The Kshetra is the Garbhashaya. The Bija is, in case of male, it is sperm. In case of female, it is egg, that is ovum. Ambu is the water, the nutrition, which has to be there. With the nutrition only, the further fertilization and the growth of people happens. So if there is any problem with these four portions, any problem with the Rutu, any problem with the Kshetra, any problem with the Bija, next to Ambu, there won't be conception, and then they end up with having the infertility issue. And there are also, there is Shadbhavas, which we speak, a unique thing in Ayurveda. Shadbhavas, that is Satmija, Satvija, Rasaja, Matruja, Pitruja Bhava, all this, and also they say Atmaja Bhava, which is very, very unique to Ayurveda. See, whatever happens, this Sukshya, everything happens, the fertilization happens, but that soul has to come and reside. The soul comes and resides in the embryo only, then the live pregnancy happens, and then she'll be able to deliver a live child. So that Shadbhavas are also very important. What is the percentage of infertility? What is the current study estimates overall incidence infertility at 10 to 15% of the married couple. So in that, you may be astonished to find out if in that total 10 to 15% of married couple, 50% they have a female sterility issue. Equal to that, 50% is a male sterility issue. In the beginning, in earlier era, they used to think that only woman is a target for infertility. She is the only problem because of her disease, she is unable to bear the child. But it is definitely not true. We are finding equal percentage of male sterility about the on the female sterility also. So classification, how do we classify it according to Ayurveda? The primary infertility. See, this is what we call it as, they have not at all conceived. After marriage, maybe the couple come to us for 3 years of marriage, 4 years. It's not even once they have a pregnancy positive test or they have missed their period. That is called a prajavandeva. So far, the no cures. Secondary infertility is sapraja. So previous, there will be one conception, but they will fail to conceive for the second one. That is called as secondary infertility. It is called as saprajavandeva. Then there is another thing which we commonly come across in urban places like Bangalore. This is pregnancy wastage. That is repeated miscarriages called as a garbhasravi vandita. The spontaneous abortion, and also even stillbirth is also considered as pregnancy wastage. So in this thing, what happens? The woman conceives, but she'll not be able to carry on that live pregnancy till the delivery. In between, maybe in the first trimester, there can be abortions, second trimester abortions, or third trimester, intrauterine death, or all these things happen. So usually what we have to think in first trimester, if there is any abortion happening repeated, maybe 2-3 times, they miss the period, urine pregnancy test becomes positive, but when you do the scan, there is no gestational sac or the fetal not present, then it is called as chemical pregnancy. Only the chemicals changes in that pregnancy, but there is no real gestational sac and the fetal not. Second thing, what happens, there is a chemical changes happening and there's gestational sac, but they fail to have the fetal node and the cardiac activity. So only when we see a cardiac activity between the 6 and 7 weeks of our pregnancy, then it's a live pregnancy. Otherwise, it is called as pregnancy wastage, and there has to be spontaneously, sometimes they abort. Otherwise, you will give some of the medicines to make them abort. So the next, female infertility, the etiology, what are all the etiology? I come to the causes in females. So let us not take a male, because I'm only dealing with the female issues. This yoni pradosha. Yoni, what are all the things which consider the yoni is an anatomical organ. In that, what all we have to consider in yoni pradosha? Abnormality of organs. See, it is genital reproductive organs. First, we have to start with the vagina, and then the cervix, and then the uterus, and then the tubes, and then the ovaries. So these are all the 5 stages of the reproductive organ, wherein there may be anatomical issues. The yoni pradosha means there can be, as I said, euphoria problem, infections problem, vaginitis problem, which will not allow the healthy sperms to enter the uterus and then fertilize with the egg, number one cause. Second thing, the vaginitis can proceed without an indication. If you are not treated, the vaginitis problem will further go up and then cause cervicitis. The erosion around the cervix, there is a mucus discharge, purulent discharge, all these will make the sperm which is ejaculated in the vagina to die there only, so not reach the tubes, fertilize the eggs. Then comes the uterus. There can be so many problems, the malformations of the uterus and the fibroid uterus, and then there is adenomyosis of the uterus, and there is so many other causes of the uterine pathology, wherein fertilization happens in the tubes, but for implantation may not happen if the endometrium of the uterus is not supportive, if it is not patient should be there to the endometrium, and then it should be a triple layered endometrium to come and get implanted. If the embryo to come and get implanted, you need a good endometrium. So this is also a problem of the. And endometriosis, as I said, now this comes. Endometriosis is a patchy endometrium in the uterus, which will not allow the fertilized embryo to get implanted. The next problem is artha doshas, as it is all the genetic causes have problem, like, you know, like major causes with the genetics, like, you know, small sized uterus, infantile uterus, and then all these are the problem with genetic causes. So our gonadotrophins problem, no proper like chandatva and all these, there is no proper sexual this one. These are all genetic causes wherein he will fail to become a pregnant. Then balakshaya, according to Ayurveda, as Dr. Balendra Prakash mentioned now, immunological immunomodulators have lot of drugs have immunomodulation effect. So this balakshaya, because of balakshaya, lack of immunity, though the pregnancy happens. As I said, there is a pregnancy wastage will happen because of balakshaya, immunological disorders. The lady will not accept the pregnancy, and then that will not, the pregnancy will not continue till the date of delivery. So the condition will support, we will have to support with the immune modulator drugs, like mainly we have this Shatavari, Dariva, Manjishta, Ashwagandha. All these are very good medicines which will improve the immunological factor of the woman. So next is Phalita Mutratva. As I said, infectious, I have already covered, like vaginitis, I told, these are all the infectious causes, and also in the tubes, salpingitis. What happens if the tubes are affected with infection, and if the pelvic inflammatory disease is there in the uterus, the tubes will bloat up, will become hydrosalpinx. There is no movement of the tubes, so that the sperm cannot be carried to the tubes, because tubes are the a place where the implied the fertilization happens. So when there is tubal problem, then definitely sperm cannot swim up and reach the site of the egg. So then the hormonal process is very, very important. Now everybody is very conversant with this PCOD term. The PCOD is polycystic ovarian disorder, or it can be called as polycystic ovarian syndrome. These are all affected with, the one thing is overweight. Because of nowadays wrong eating and junk food eating, not nutritious eating, many girls not having proper physical exercise and being overweight. Because overweight is one of the main features of polycystic ovaries. Second one is irregular periods. That is the commonest problem in a PCOD patient. And irregular ovulation, irregular periods, overweight, and many a times is hypothyroidism. Thyroid is such a common problem nowadays. If we have about 100 patients, 60 to 70 patients will have this thyroid issue, hypothyroidism. Then the hyperprolactinemia is the lactation. What happens, the prolactin hormone becomes hyper, and then there is the estrogen become lesser. So the ovulation does not happen. So they end up having this irregular periods, irregular ovulation. In turn, it will lead to infertility. So I'm just taking you around that wide survey of all these problems, because we have very good treatment for PCOD. First, we have to tackle the overweight. See, according to Ayurveda, we have this beautiful Panchakarma Shodhana therapies. So unless we advise this Shodhana therapy to detox the system, whatever the doshas which have accumulated for a long time because of wrong abuse of the body, so that we have to detox first. Either according to the Ritu wise, you can select Vechana, Mana, or along with that, even the Basti also be recommended. Sometimes this thyroidal issues or hypothalamo axis problem, we have to advise even the Rasya problem, Rasya therapy also. By doing all these Panchakarma treatments, like Vechana, the Shodhana treatment, afterwards you start giving Satyuda medicine, which are Arthava improvement that you have to give, and then definitely they will respond very well. Then what are all the investigations which are important to do it? So because whenever a patient, a couple come to us, they look very normal. So usually the age of the couple who come to us is between 25, 28 years to 35 years, but up to 40 years. So at that age, they will be definitely, physically they are looking good. Everything will be good. Their attitude will be good. Nourishment, everything will be good, but still they will having the problem of infertility. How do you come across their problem? So first you have to send them for ultrasound scanning to monitor ovulation. This is a simple non-invasive method of identifying or diagnosing the patient. If we send the patient, a female patient, to the ultrasound scanning to monitor follicle development, the follicle is the one which starts developing from day one or day two of the cycle, wherein it reaches the size of about 2 centimeters, wherein it is called as a mature follicle, then it opens up and ruptures. When it ruptures, it should rupture naturally. If there is an ovulation, that is called as ovulation. That we will get to know by doing ultrasound scanning. So the next one is hysterosalpingogram. Yeah, as I said, tube is also playing a very important role in conception. When there is a problem in the tubes, if there is a blockage, do this hysterosalpingogram. You will come to know whether the tubes are patent or tubes are blocked. If the tubes are patent, you can concentrate more on ovulation and you make them conceive. If the tubes having the block, but there are very few medication, see, all Lakenia drugs we have used to clear the tubes. Simple salpingitis or some infection can be. So like Varunadi Kashaya, we have Lakenia drugs, Varunadi Kashaya. We also give this Arjimona Mexicana, that is Varanakshiri treatment, the Panchanga of the fresh weed of that Varanakshiri. We give it post period for about 5 to 6 days, and there have been few very good cases who responded with tubal block with us. So afterwards they were able to conceive. The lady was good. But nowadays, because IVF has become more popular, so for the procedure of IVF, tubes are not required. So they mostly go for this IVF treatment wherever they find this tubal problem. The next overall view of the uterus can be got laparoscopy and hysteroscopy, find out any tubo-peritoneal diseases, any endometriosis, any ovarian cyst, any PCOS, all can be made out, even the blockage of the tubes and the bicornate and unicornate uterus, all problems of anatomical part, everything will can be made out with laparoscopy and hysteroscopy. So please advise them to go for a laparoscopy and hysteroscopy if they fail to conceive for few years after marriage. Then what else management? How do you manage infertility? As I said, garbhashodhana to be done. And then shamana is like arthava vruddhikara. What is other like mari, musta, chitaka, sariva, manjishta, shugandha? All these are very good in arthava vruddhikara. And garbhasthapta drugs are very, very important. Nowadays we are finding a lot of problem patients with IVF failures. One or two times they fail because of lack of implantation. Endometrium is not proper. Endometrium is not supporting. Such is the condition, then we have to advise garbhasthapta drugs. And the, in the form of ghee, it is very good. All these can be given to make them hold on to the embryo in the uterus. Then the other important uniprakshalana, because of those vaginitis or cervicitis problem, repeated abortions can happen, or maybe the cervical incompetence. I have had a few patients with cervical incompetence. Usually, whoever has got the second trimester abortion, first you have to look for cervical incompetence. Because of cervical incompetence, the pregnancy will not go forward. And they, because of incompetence, their cervix become open and they have the abortion with that. So for that, we have done what preconceptionally. Anyhow, one or two abortions will happen and they will even do cervical sarcology. They put the stitch. In spite of stitch, about two patients they have aborted. So what they have recommended them is, I asked them to come preconception. Before they plan for pregnancy, they are asked to come to our clinic. And then we counsel them. We give all the medicines, uterine muscles, and the infection will go along with the medication. We also do this yoni prakshalana and pitcha. Yoni prakshalana can be according to the doshas, like kapha, vata, pitta. We can select these kashayas, like kapala kashaya, dushmala kashaya, and kapala kashaya. Any of the choices based on the dosha dominance. Then you do this yoni prakshalana for a period of about 3 to 5 days post menstruation. And the bleeding should have stopped, and then take them. And then you do pichu also. It's very good. Pichu, if there is
a Mamari, sorry to interfere in between, since we are a little strict about the timings. Almost week is to go. Kindly conclude. Thank you, ma'am. Okay. Sorry to interfere.
No, it's okay. So this is non-specific sterility, which I just told you. Sorry. Words have you put. Tattva Vajya Chikitsa has a very great importance. As according to Charaka, emphasizes Somanasyam Garbhadharanam. You all know that area, at that time only he has expressed how important is the happy stuff. Very important. And you just take out all these post-delivery problems. And menopause, of course, we have a lot of problems with menopause, like osteoarthritis and dysfunctional uterine bleeding and collapse of the uterus. And TF, cervix, ovaries, breast, anal, vaginitis, very common problem which people come across this. And survey, this is the last slide which I'm showing. 10% of the women in the reproductive years have chronic gynecological problem. 30% of them spend one or more. This you have to see. Being a woman, they spend one in bed every month with this. So wide spectrum of drugs are available to treat this, but a majority of them are hormonal patients that are known to possess untoward side effects. So what are we doing? Aushadha prayoga, like shamana chikitsa can be done, shodhana chikitsa can be done, and rasayana chikitsa can be done. So all these, you know, in according to Ayurveda, we have an excellent remedy for this. And then we have to make a woman healthy. Srihi moolam apathyanam srihi rakshati. This is the message, carry on message, take home message for all of you. Thank you so much once again for the organizers who gave me the opportunity to present before you all. Thank you so much once again. Namaste.